Hi guys, what's up? How are you? Welcome to my channel, fellow wine lovers and folks from all over the world. So today we're gonna talk about the top, best, fair value, good value Argentinian wines that you can find in the market right now under $20. Absolutely great, great value. The aim of this video and this series of videos that I made talking about wines at the best value from all over the world is to give you an overview, an idea of the best grapes variety of that country, of that area, okay? The best expression of that terroir, giving the sense of the place. That is basically my main focus, my main goal with this series. So let's start immediately with position number 5. In position number 5, we have a unique grape variety that grows very well only in Argentina, that is the Torrontes. Torrontes by Zuccardi, and you can get this wine at an average price of $15. So Torrontes, why it is so special? Because it is a semi-aromatic grape, and it is a cross of Criolla Chica and Moscato of Alexandria. Moscato of Alexandria is very aromatic, it's one of the aromatic grapes, and it is that being crossed with an indigenous grape of Argentina, and it grows perfectly in Salta, and you have all these notes of lychee, a bit of orange peel as well, with a nice crispiness and white spices either in the nose and in the palate. And it goes extremely well with all the seafood, the salad, but also Asian food works extremely well in general. All the aromatic grapes or semi-aromatic wines are perfectly matched with Asian food and a bit of spices. And so Zuccardi is one of the most famous producers. They also produce Malbec in Mendoza, but this one has a very, very great value and good quality. So I hope you have the chance to try with a lovely seafood. In position number 5, we have Trapiche or Trapique Estacion 8083 Bonarda 2017 for $16. And it is not the Bonarda that you might think from Italy. It doesn't have nothing to do actually with that Bonarda. This one is known in France like Douce Noir, or maybe in the US like Charbono or Carbono. Please pardon my pronunciation. And it is a medium full red grapes that grows particularly well in Argentina, in Mendoza. It is growing quite a lot actually in popularity, because it has this very nice and lovely red plum with these spices, a lot of spices in the very well integrated. They are able to manage very well the aging process of this wine. And this makes a wine perfect for a great variety of dishes or rich pastas, the asado from there especially. And Trapiche has a beautiful winery as well in Malbec, in the Heart, in Mendoza. And as you can see here, also the estate is quite modern, quite chic, I would say also. And limestone, a lot of limestone they have on the soil that gives all these also minerality and crispiness to the wines and drain well the water. And so basically this wine is absolutely beautiful. It has also a quite smoky tones. This is the main feature also, with a bit of licorice on the nose as well, is a main feature of this wine, unique, and it is a very great expression of this terroir. So I hope you have the chance to try this Bonarda from Trapiche or Trapique. So I hope you're enjoying the video. I hope you enjoy my channel. If this is the case, consider subscribing to the channel and smashing the like button. This will will help me a lot in making more videos. So this channel is about you. I want to give you the best tips and recommendation from a sommelier that studied in different schools in Italy and in the UK, and it's working currently still in prestigious restaurants here in London. So I want to give you the best secrets behind wine, the wine world, which are the best wines, the most expensive, but also the best value one, and how you can appreciate at their best these wines. So the best features, the best secret and techniques to really enjoy this wine perfectly. So I hope you enjoy the channel, subscribe, and let's move on with position number three. And finally, in position number three, we have Malbec. Probably is the most representative grape variety of all Argentina. For sure, is the most famous. And Vina Cobos produced this lovely Malbec 2019 for $16. Very, very fair value for a very, very great grape variety. So this, how it is Malbec? Malbec is a medium to full body red wine with this purple red color. Quite intense and concentrated black fruits, a little bit of graphite as well, and spices due to the aging in barrels, and tannins. But the tannins here are quite rounded, quite velvety, so it seems like pass me the term, quite similar to a Merlot, but even with more acidity, but to give an idea of sense of the roundiness of the wine, okay? So it is very, very popular all over the world. It gained absolutely outstanding popularity and also quality. They increase a lot the quality. And Vina Cobos has the vineyard, and it is situated in Luan de Cuyo, that probably is the highest part of Mendoza. You see really the Andes in there, and they get also these shock thermics. They have even their limestone gravels, a lot of alluvial deposit, and the climate is a kind of semi-desertic climate, so a lot of sun, low rains, they need irrigation often, and a lot of winds coming down from the grapes, from the Andes. So very, very healthy. They almost all produce organically in there. They don't need really almost any pesticide. So the vines, as I said, are quite high. They get a lot of sun light before they get full ripeness. Valle de Uco and Valle de Cuyo are the regions where they source these Malbec to make this wine. And it is absolutely fantastic with soft cheeses, I would say, and also red meat and pasta. Very versatile Malbec. So beautiful, 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 very fair value. So in position number two, we have a lovely Chardonnay by Terrat de los Andes for $18. Chardonnay here is grew in a high altitude. Even here we are in Mendoza, in Valle del Uco. Terrat de los Andes means that they are really close to the Andes. This also estate belongs to a big luxury group, LVMH. So they know what they do. So Chardonnay here has a very nice fruity character of tropical fruit, but with a very nice minerality due to the soil rich in limestone and alluvial deposit as well. A little bit of gravel, but there is a big, big layer of limestone. So like in Burgundy, to give an idea. So here, high altitude, great sunlight, organic cultivation, great exposition, semi-desertic climate makes this Chardonnay absolutely unique, and with a very, very fair price. So $18 for a wine like this are really spent very, very well. And so here we can see that Terrat de los Andes is literally not far from the Andes, and they produce these lovely from Valle Chardonnay, from Valle del Uco, Riserva, and it is aged a bit in oak, so we have a little bit of also white spices, and it is left also on lees, so you have this also lingery palate, well balanced by the acidity overall as well. The vineyards are at 1250 meters, so quite high, and also there is the classic character of nuttiness, a little bit of buttery note due to the malolactic fermentation or partial malolactic fermentation. So this goes very very well with white meat, I would say, or veggie pastas in general, and you won't regret absolutely this lovely Chardonnay. And in position number one we have again Terrazza de los Andes, this time with a very nice Cabernet Sauvignon. And you say, but it might be a little bit too cold in there. Well, they cultivate this Cabernet Sauvignon at a lower altitude than the Malbec and the Chardonnay, but still quite cool, so it develops less body, it's more on the elegant side. That's why it's super super well balanced, super well made. Okay, so even here Terrazza de los Andes, we are in facing the Andes, we are a little bit in the lower altitude, we have these black cassis, leathery, very well integrated tannins, as I said, and a nice plummy notes as well, very very long finish, and with a very very great age potential for this wine. So Terrazza de los Andes really make a very super elegant Cabernet Sauvignon. To give you an idea, maybe like maybe Sonoma, more on the cool side, instead of Napa that is a bit bolder, but this one is probably one that I prefer, and it is a really really nice representation of Cab. They also make a lovely Malbec in Terrazza de los Andes, of course, but it was a little bit more expensive than $20, so couldn't go within the video basically. So I hope, really hope you have the chance to try this beautiful wine also with the Chardonnay and the Cab. And you can source this wine in the website that I put in the description here below. So I hope you enjoyed the video, I hope you found the value, I hope you found the labels and producer that you didn't know and that you can source, or maybe you knew this, so let me know in the description below with your comments which one was your favorite, if you have tried them, or which one you would like to try between these selection. I'm really really curious and I would like to know your opinion. Also, again, if you want to source this wine, you can find the link here in the description, as you can find all the links to the other videos similar from other countries, from Chile, Spain, Italy, California, and so on. So here in the description you can find everything. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If this is the case, consider subscribing to the channel, smash the like button, and I hope to see you in the next one. Ciao, see you next time.